in which I am asked to alter the law of gravity. Op is me. EU is end user. Phone rings. Op. IT department, this is redacted speaking. How can I help you? End user. The lid to my scanner keeps falling and hurting my hand. Can you make it slow down? Op. I'm sorry, I don't quite understand. The lid to the scanner keeps falling? End user. When I lift it up to put a document in it, it doesn't stay open long enough and it hits my hand as I'm placing the document. I was wondering if you could make it slow down so I have time to pull my hand out. At this point, I figure that the best thing to do is to just walk up to the office to observe the phenomenon in person. I watch the user open the scanner up halfway, letting go before it's in the locking position. The scanner lid falls onto end user's hand. Op. If you open the scanner up a bit more, the lid will go into a locking position so it doesn't fall on your hand. End user. Well, if I do that, all the papers fall out. Question mark. End user puts a stack of papers in the output tray and opens the lid to the locking position, which dumps the papers out of the tray. Op. Could you just take the papers out of the tray before you scan a new document? End user. Sigh. Well, I guess I could do that. But it didn't used to fall down that fast. Can't you just make it fall slower somehow? Lost 2 years of work on hundreds of millions of dollars worth of business accounts today in 20 minutes. I work as a help desk tech for a midsize financial institution. Today had to be the single biggest user F-up I've ever witnessed in my 5 years in this industry. Down the rabbit hole we go. This computer illiterate but very nice lady, who had no business using a laptop due to all the particular quirks that it entails with our security build out, and her boss asked me to reimage her laptop to address system instability issues. Sent me an email explicitly stating in bold that all files were saved to her network drive and her local HDD had not been updated since 2017. Only the parts about where she saved her files were bolded, which just makes this even juicier. I reimage the laptop, wiping it clean. Reinstall everything, smooth sailing, and the laptop is running great. I escort user back to their office to get everything situated, configure displays, pair peripheral Bluetooth devices, accessibility options, etc. Everything is done and running like new. Well, they had their, now documented, facts backwards about where her work was saved. Goodbye 2 years worth of work on hundreds of millions of dollars worth of business accounts. We, and CyberSec, both scanned the entire network for any copies, none. Rolled back her personal network folder to 2 days before the reimage, most recent files were from 2017. No traces anywhere. Not a single file had been saved anywhere but good ol' C. And she was the only person who touched these files in the last 2 years. A cautionary tale to be sure. Mandatory periodic computer literacy courses for your generation gapped employees, my friends. Don't skip it. Don't give passes. There are of course many angles to consider regarding what measures could have been in place to prevent this, but at the end of the day current, likely to change after this though, company policy completely absolves us from responsibility for users failing to save their data where they have been clearly instructed to. It also states that all local copies are considered their personal responsibility to back up. Saying hello will cripple the entire organization. I'm a cybersecurity engineer for a fairly large organization. Few dozen locations, 10,000 users, 120,000 IP address leases internally. We have 12 servers running software that convert raw data from our main software into beautiful readable PDFs. They process around 100,000 requests a day. I get a call from the sysadmin of these servers. Dot. Sysadmin. Hey Goblin, every month the software crashes and we have to reboot the servers. We lose hundreds of print jobs doing this. Vendor says it's the vulnerability scanner. Me. Makes sense. The vulnerability scanning happens every month and it might be trying to feed those servers bad requests to try to exploit a security hole. Vendor gets conferenced in. Vendor. You need to turn off all scanning to these two network ports because the software takes any data to these ports and tries to print it. I think for a moment, there's no way I understood that right. Me. To clarify, any data to those network ports gets interpreted by the software. No error handling or security checks? Vendor. That is correct. Yes, we have to have other clients turn a vulnerability and port scanning. Me. So, wait, if I open up NMAP right now and have my computer say, hello port, are you open and what service name are you, then it'll crash the whole environment? Vendor. Well, yes, that is correct. Me, that's not supportable. Please have a fix for this soon. Vendor, I'll talk to the developer. Dot, this isn't some rinky-dinky fly-by-night software. This is a fairly popular software solution used by others in my industry. Incredible. Thanks for watching and don't forget to give a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Have a good one.